Hey, what's good, y'all? It's Diz back again with another video. So today we're gonna do a tutorial on how to draw lips using dry pastel. We got my girl here, Viola Davis, on the cover of Elle magazine. So we have these new pastel Prismacolor dry pastels. I'm gonna be one of these now. I can't believe I'm really doing that, but yeah, this is like a lot more colors. My professor let me hold these. Y'all understand how beautiful that is. But I also have these Artist Loft dry pastels that my girl Vonna got me. Thank you, girl. And so yeah, we're going to get into it. Some overall tips that I want to give before we get started, if you're interested, is to, you can always blend with your finger. You can use cotton balls, you can use Q-tips, or you can use a napkin. Personally, I like to use my fingers because I'll be getting my hand dirty. And I sort of think of it as like painting. So you can put your base and then mid-tones, highlights, whatever. Whatever process makes you feel most comfortable. A lot of people like to say work from dark to light or light to dark. I tend to just go in order of the image. I don't really care about that specific order, but highlights usually are last for me. So I guess I'll work from dark to light. You gotta protect the jammies, you know what I'm saying? Always make sure you got some sort of smock or apron, I guess you would call this. Gotta protect the fit, you feel me? Gotta stay fresh. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is grab one of your pastels that you want to use for a base color or like a medium. So not really a highlight or a shadow. The pastel that I used before was the 256-P. Whatever this one was, whatever this one was did not do well. As you can see, the texture is just horrendous. So I'm gonna try this color instead, and hopefully we can like darken it up, lighten it up in places that we need to later. So first you want to do is cover up the whole thing and get that going as like the base color of the lips. And then once you finish that, you want to blow it off. Gotta blow it off. Next, I'm going to come in with the dark brown where I think the places are, where the shadows are, just so I know. And I have my reference sitting in my lap. Just so I know where the shading is going to be. And then I can use my finger to blend that out. Now, for anybody that's just using this, don't be so hard on yourself when you start. Don't be coming in here having no high expectations of like, oh my God, it's about to be a masterpiece like immediately. It's really not. It's gonna take a lot of time for you to like understand where the lights and shadows are, stuff like that. So just take your time with it, you know, it's all good. So next, sometimes you gotta like experiment. I'm gonna try and see what this brown does, cause it's really not that pink. And I'm gonna see how that reacts to it. While also making sure that the proportions are lined up correctly. Okay, so just like that. Next, I'm gonna go in with this dark gray just to like define the shadows a little bit more so I understand what the shape of the lip is inside, under it, etc. So yeah, just, you know, a little bit of cracking there. And there we go. Next, I'm gonna go with this. What is this? What color is this? Old Rose. And edit where the highlight is on her lip. Soon as I get this paper open. So now I know that's gonna be on half of the mouth over here, a little bit over here, a little bit right there, and maybe like a tad bit right there. Then we're gonna blend it in, child. We're gonna blend it in. So as you can see, there's a little bit of depth coming out already. And we like that. But her lips are definitely a bit more burgundy, so I'm gonna see if I can add a different kind of red or some sort of reddish brown color just to make it look more natural, because I don't like that. This pink is just too much for me, child. And so, sometimes when you like doing stuff like that, you don't really got all the colors that you would like to use for what you want to make. And so, when I got this blush up here, I used that pink, but it's not the same shade for the lips. So, it's a little irritating, but you gotta work with what you got. You gotta get it how you live in. So what can you do? So I decided to use the big boys from the Artist Loft pack, because like I have that too. I don't know why I didn't think to use that before. But we're gonna redden her up, because I don't like that pink. That was a little too much pink for me. We don't need all that extraness. And then I'm gonna go back with the dark just to line it up, because we love a good lip liner. And so since this brown is already right there, I'm gonna go back with the dark gray so we can darken that up, so that we can let the viewers know that, hey, the lip shape is actually like this. Go back with the brown. Sometimes you can blend using the pastel itself, which I typically like to use, because not only does it save my fingers from getting extra messy, it reminds me of painting even more, which I like. And so now I'm just gonna lapse it for I guess a little bit remainder for the other highlights and details and stuff like that, but like, you get the gist. This is the gist of having the shadows, highlight, and mid-tone of a lip. But now I'm gonna time lapse the details of like the lines, creases, wrinkles, and stuff like that. And yeah, also just wanna, can we appreciate this glitter lip gloss? Like, oh my god. Anyway, yeah. And real quick, I just wanna say, when you're adding like the wrinkles on the lips, just try not to overthink too much about how they look, cause 9 times out of 10, they're really, like, obviously the Lord don't do anything on random, but when you're drawing it, just like do random lines, and then when you take a step back to look at it, then it'll make more sense. But just don't overthink it and just do what you gotta do, okay, to get the details and stuff like that. So I'm gonna go with the darker gray on this end, because that's shadows. And now we're adding other wrinkles. A little bit over here, yeah. And then make sure with the top over here, you're going in lines like this, so that it makes it look like it's like coming out. Same thing down here, make sure your lines are coming out like the shape of a lip.
because that's super important. And so the last thing, my bell just peeking. So the last thing that you want to do is use the same method, but like with the highlights, but not too much for real, because yeah, we don't want to make it more glossy than it is. So again, with that swoop line work, following the dark and mid-tones, and add a little bit over here. Solidify that again. A little bit down here. And yeah. I'm gonna blend that out because it's not really a solid line for real. And I also want to add like more brown over here, because it's not that light, as I said. And you can always add more lines later. Okay, so now that's better. Add a little bit of red at the bottom here. Back with the brown. Gray. And then if you want to go a little bit deeper in your hues, sometimes you can add like this darker blue to mix with the gray sometimes. It makes it better. Here you poo. And I'm gonna go back with the highlights, but I think I'm gonna use white this time just because it's different than the pink. And it's like a little bit brighter for real. So then that'll like exaggerate the highlight a little bit more, which we like to do. We like to exaggerate a little bit. Okay, period. I don't know how that's translating on the camera, but girl, these lips is juicy, you feel me? Go ahead, Viola, Miss Viola. A piece of paper coming off right there, but it's all good. It's all good. Now I'm gonna use the dark brown right here. And then again with the white. I see that highlight goes all the way down. Like that. And then we're gonna mix it a little bit at the bottom because it's not that. Okay. And then I'm gonna use this darker gray to like line it a little bit more. Because she does have on a lip liner. And then I'm gonna mix it with the brown, see if that does anything. You can't be afraid to experiment, folks, because you don't know unless you try it. Amen. So we just going to mix that, see if that works. Okay, I think it did something. Bet. And when I'm mixing this, the first color is on there with a lot more pressure. Then you go back with the second color, a little bit lighter. Not as pressure, but just following along. Like, literally just, like, kind of doing it lightly. I don't know if that makes sense, and I don't know if y'all can like see, but you obviously can't feel what I'm doing. But like, yeah, and bam, and here you got some lips.
So hope y'all enjoyed this tutorial about how to draw lips with dry pastel. As you can see, we have our luscious lips on Viola completed. Not mine, child. Anyway, yeah, don't be discouraged about how it looks in the beginning. As you can see, it has to get worse before it gets better. Keep being creative. Never stop making art. Art is important and essential for the world to go around. All right, thank you. So I hope you learned something. Come back and tune in, because I can also do a tutorial on the chin, the cheekbones, the rest of it, for real, for real. If you want to learn how to use dry pastel, holla at your girl. I can teach you. So come back again, and thank you all so much if you made it to the end of this video. And let me know. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at dez.thaniel. Don't forget to add me on Facebook, same thing, Des.Thaniel. And don't forget to tune in on my TikTok. That is at Black Quartz, BlackQuartz. Boom. Also want to say thank you all for the questions from my previous video. Keep them coming. Some people ask more questions after I made the video, so I might answer them in like the next one. So if you have any other questions or like other art tips about dry pastel, drop them in the comments and I'll make a video about it, because why not? So yeah, thanks again for tuning in. I appreciate you. I'll see you later at the next one.